Hey guys, Josh here. So I thought I'd do a little walkthrough, kind of a video tutorial on how to make custom textures. I made a post about it a while ago, but I thought I'd make a video and kind of show it live. I know sometimes reading something and seeing it done can make the difference between being able to do it and not being able to do it. So let's go ahead and get started. So I asked if anyone had a cool idea for a vehicle texture, and I guess some Kevin Bacon Jeep textures are what we're going to be going after today. So to get started, if you have don't have Photoshop or something else, I recommend using Gimp. It's free and it's a lot of things you can do with it. And I have these all linked in the original post on how to make custom skins. So after you get Gimp, you want to get PBOManager. This lets us go inside the PBOs and get the PAA files we want to work with. And lastly, we need to get TexView2. So this one, you actually download the entire thing, and in the installation process, you can check which programs you want to install, and you can just check TextView. So I already have all that stuff installed. So next step would be finding the texture we want to edit. So we're looking for the Jeep texture, and in ARMA, that's called, I believe, the MB4WD. So I'm going to go to my Explorer here, and I'll just walk you through how I get here. So go to your local disk, probably C drive, go to Program Files 86, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, and then ARMA 3. Now in here, most textures, or most of the vehicles and stuff in game are going to be in add-ons, but if it's like a DLC, like the go-karts or like the vans, it's going to be in the expansion folder, I believe. So in here we have another folder called add-ons. And then what we can do is we can open up Chrome. Let me open up a new window here. We can go to BI Studio. What is that? .com. I think that'll take us to it. Once we're here, you can click on Community and go to the Wiki. Let's search for assets. And this first one here, ARMA 3 assets. This lets us view all the assets in the game. So I'm going to go underneath Civilian. I'm going to do Control F, just search the page, MB4WD, oops, MB4WD, and there it is. So over here we can see where it's located, so ARMA 3 Soft F Expansion Off-Road 02. So that's the name we're looking for. Before I actually knew about this, I was always digging through all the folders trying to find it, and this tells you exactly where it is. So we're looking for Soft F, so we'll go down to S, Soft F. FEXP expansion. So we're going to open this, and this is where PBO Manager comes in. So we're going to expand this. We're looking for Off-Road 2. There it is. We'll open this, go underneath Theta, and the texture is one of these. So here's like olive, orange, red. I'm guessing these are going to be the files. So you can see we have the TextView2 logo there, which means it's going to open with TextView2, and we can view our textures here. So this is the orange texture, and we'll work with this. I'm going to go to File, Save As, and I'll just call this, we'll just leave it as it is, but we'll end it with PNG. I'm going to save it as a PNG file. Actually, I have no clue where I just saved that to. Okay, it's in my documents. I'm going to go ahead and take that and move it to my desktop. Let's make a new folder while we're at it. MB4WD texture. I'm going to take our orange texture, drag it, and drop it in there. So next up, whatever design you're going to be using, let's search Kevin Bacon. Now this step is going to take a little bit longer, so I'm probably going to edit this down a little bit. So this is my first texture. Let's go ahead and put it in ARMA 3 and see how it actually looks. Because sometimes there are little things, you know, like, I don't want paint there. So we're going to actually put it in the ARMA editor. So let me go ahead and fire up ARMA 3 here. Okay, so we're going to go to single player and open the editor. Let's go to virtual reality. I only go to virtual reality because there's less scenery to load, so it's a little bit faster. So we're going to put down any playable character. I'm just going to put down one of the civilians. Then we're going to put down two of the thing that we're texturing or reskinning. Go ahead and delete this driver here. I'm going to copy this. Make another copy. Okay. Now another thing I wanted to show you, and I'll do this in a second. I'll just go ahead and call this MB here. And I'll name this one Grade. And I'll show you I'm naming this one Grade in a second. Take my guy, flip him around here. And let's save the scenario. Doesn't matter what you save it as, you just have to save it. So let's go back into GIMP. And another tip, make sure if you're going to be doing lots of textures, put ARMA 3 in a windowed mode so you can hop between things without it taking forever to switch. So I'm going to go ahead and export this. I'm going to call this MB1. You want a really short name, one that's easy to remember, and we're going to do it going up. Because every time we make a change, we can't save it as the same name. ARMA needs a new name. So we're going to call this MB1. We're going to go to Documents, ARMA 3 Other Profiles, the name of your account, Missions, and then open the mission that you just saved, which is MB4WD Texture. And it has to be a JPEG. ARMA 3 can work with the PAA files and JPEG, but unfortunately it can't work with PNG. And of course, TexView2 had to export as PNG, so make sure you save it as a JPEG. Export, I like to use 100. Quality. Let's jump into ARMA here. So we named this. This is the one that we named MB. So this is the one we're going to put the texture on. So play in single player. We're going to just load up. We're going to press escape. Go to the debug console here. You can see I was doing this the other night. So this first part is the name. So in this case, it's going to be MB, capital. I believe it's case sensitive. Then we're going to do set object texture, space, bracket, 0, if there's a vehicle that has multiple textures, like for example, a Mohawk has 3 different textures. One's like the tail boom, one's the main body, and one is the rotors, I think, at least. So 0 just tells it which part of the vehicle texture to look for. In most vehicle cases, it's going to be 0 because there's only one texture. Comma, and then in quotations, I think we save this as mb1.jpg. Brackets, and then whatever that thing is. Then local execution, cross your fingers, that black Jeep should turn into a Kevin Bacon Jeep. Hey, would you look at that? So this is where you kind of just inspect the vehicle, see if there's anything you want to change. Like say, I'm trying to think of an example, if there's something I want to change here. So say I didn't want the windshield or the paint around the windshield to be changed. If I Alt-Tab back here, turn off my layers, I'm going to try to look at this texture and see what part is the window frame. Well, this might be it over here. This looks like it might be it. I mean, this, if I had a bit money, this is probably it, but I'm not sure. Just the way the texture is laid out, it's all chopped up in little pieces. It's really hard to tell where small little things are. So what we can do is create a new layer. We're going to go to our gradient tool. We're going to choose, where's our, yep, spectrum, linear. I'm going to go ahead and apply a gradient to that. Look at that, a rainbow. So I have red, yellow, green, turquoise, blue, purple, all that good stuff. I'm going to lower the opacity. I'm going to copy our off-road. So I'm going to lower the opacity. You can see we can start to see through it. It becomes less opaque. Is that how opacity works? I just want a little bit of color. So we always have our original down here. I'm gonna merge this down. And look at that. We have a texture that's rainbow colored. Let's go ahead and export this as grade, G-R-A-D, JPEG. And export that into our missions folder. And I'll show you what's really cool about this. If I go back to the editor, now I could do it from here. I can do the same thing. I don't wanna just go to a new line because I like new lines. We named this one grade. That's the name of our asset, our object. Set, object, texture, space, bracket, zero, comma, quotes, the name. We just saved as grade.jpg. JPEG, quote, bracket, whatever the hell that thing is. And look at that. We can run that, and here it is. So I can now tell that the around the window is going to be yellow, and then it turns a little bit orange at the top. So if I go back to GIMP, let's see. So this part is blue and kind of green, but this part right here is yellow, and it turns to orange. So my bet paid off. I kind of knew where it was, but to 100% confirm it without actually changing it over and over again, I can use this gradient to match colors. So this is definitely the windshield here. So say I want to make a change. Let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so this is my new texture. I'm going to go to Control Export, and I'm going to call this MB2. So this is my second version or iteration of my texture. I'm going to go back in, press Escape, and all I have to do is go change this from MB1 to MB2, local execution, and look at that. Okay, now the area around my windscreen has been removed. So say this is all we want to do. We're happy with this texture. Now it's time to export it. So we're going to go back to GIMP, go Control-Shift-E, export, and I'm just going to call this Kevin Bacon Jeep. And now we're going to export it as a PNG, because we now need to turn this back to a PAA file, and we have to do that through TextView, and TextView only works with PNGs. So we'll go ahead and save this to the desktop folder back here. Export, compression, zero. Let's open up TextView and go to File, Open, go to our desktop where we just saved that to. And there it is, Kevin Bacon Jeep. Let's open it up. There is our texture. And now we can go File, Save As, KevinBaconJeep.paa. Click Save. So if we look here, now we can see we have our PAA file, Kevin Bacon Jeep. Let's open it up. Hey, there it is. Let's go ahead and go to Altus just to see how it looks driving around the city. Let's go down to Kavala. Let's take one of our four-wheel drive vehicles, double-click on it. And we can do the set object texture right here. So I can do this. Instead of giving a name, I could just say this, since it's on the object itself. This set object texture space bracket zero comma space quotes. And hold on a second, I kind of forgot the name already. It's called Kevin Bacon Jeep. Just copy that. .paa quotes end bracket colon apostrophe thingamajig. Click OK. Now we need to save this just like we did in our other one. I'll just call this Altus test. Okay, so we're going to take this PAA, copy it, go to documents, ARMA 3 other profiles, missions, Altus test. And then we have to put that texture file where we're running the mission. So if I click play, go into single player, it should automatically load that texture, since we're telling it where to look and what file name it is. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, the majority of it is just the editing, trying to edit that texture and getting it to look real nice. Hey boy, look at that. We have a Bacon, Kevin Bacon Jeep. Oh no! Okay, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial thing. Hopefully it wasn't too boring or drawn out. Yeah,